Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen. The feast day today is Our Lady of Loreto. Loreto is a place in Italy, and it is a worldwide famous place because the Holy House of the Holy Family is located there. It was through a miracle that this house was saved, namely that angels carried it away to safety from Nazareth, first into the very eastern part of Europe, in a place called Croatia. And when that area became threatened under the Muslim occupation, the holy angels again moved the house of the Holy Family to safety in Italy, to Loreto. We, as Catholics, we must always take good care that our house, our home, also resembles those that of the Holy Family, namely the dwelling place of Jesus, Mary, and Joseph, that we are always humble and kind to each other and always want to follow the rules and commandments of our God altogether as one Catholic family. The saint of today is a child who was raised very well and who became a glorious and brave martyr. She is Saint Eulalia of Merida, which is located in Spain, and her feast is a very great feast there. She was a girl who actually lived through and made real the dream of what Saint Teresa of Avila had when she was a little girl, when she wanted to go to some Muslim country and become a glorious martyr. Well, she didn't get what she wished for, but Saint Eulalia, she did. She lived in the early part of the 4th century and in Spain, and she was raised as a Catholic to be always pious, kind, and modest. When she was growing up, she didn't like to wear any fancy clothes or decorations with those, didn't want to have any worldly or bad companions. But she already early on pledged herself to always be kind to others, to dress modestly, and remember and keep the commandments of God Almighty. And Eulalia was 12 years old when the persecutions of the cruel emperor Diocletian started. In those persecutions, all persons in the whole empire, they were ordered to prove their loyalty to the state and to the emperor by offering sacrifice to the Roman idols. Saint Eulalia, who loved Jesus very much, she saw there as her chance to become a glorious martyr, and she would wanted to have become one right away. But her mother decided to first hide her in the countryside so that the cruel persecutors could not find her. But nevertheless, she wanted to prove her loyalty to Jesus, so Saint Eulalia escaped by night's darkness back to the city of Merida. And there, in the morning, as soon as the Roman court started its sessions, Saint Eulalia arrived there, and she told the judges that she is a Catholic, and she reproached the main judge of enticing in all these cruel persecutions against Catholics. She was threatened with torture and shown all kind of horrible torture instruments, and said that it would be very easy to avoid those. Just throw a little bit of incense to the burner, which was burning before an idol, and in this way prove that you have worshipped it and you will be free to go. But no, Saint Eulalia, she threw down the idol and trampled upon the pagan sacrifices to really, really prove her point. She was a Catholic and would not worship idols. So those horrible threats, they were made true. She was ordered to be torn to pieces with hooks and then also fried with lighted torches. And the fire caught her hair and surrounded her head and face, and she was starting to choke from the smoke. But all and any voices she spoke, those were thanksgiving exclamations to God Almighty, who had allowed her to, in this wonderful way of martyrdom, to prove her love to him. And when she finally died of torture and suffocation, a white dove came out of her mouth and flew upwards to heaven. And this miracle so frightened the executioners that they escaped in terror. And then it started to snow, and the beautiful snow covered her body, so to protect her modesty in death, as she had protected it during her life. And the memory of her became so famous that whole Spain learned to love this great and brave girl, who in such a wonderful manner proved that it's always better to serve Jesus and love the Catholic faith than to escape death from the persecution and to escape death from the persecutions of the world rather than submit to do sin. So dear children, today think about this girl, Saint Eulalia. She was a kind girl and she was a brave girl. Also, it is with us that in baptism we have received sanctifying grace. And that grace of God that makes you a child of God and the child of Mary. And just like the saints did, you must always obey God first. It is sometimes very difficult, but we must always stay away from sin. And Mary always helps us to do so. And she also helps us to do the will of her Son, Jesus, in all situations, even when it seems that the whole world is against you. May God bless you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen.